order to explain what is asset management, you need to know what are assets and what is the management of assets. So what are assets? Assets can be is everything that is physical that you need to maintain, for example. So that could be a road, or it could be a sewage pipe, or it could be a gas infrastructure, it could be an electricity infrastructure. But closer to home, it could also be your car or your home. You, as a person, also own assets most of the time. And also, you are an asset manager in the sense that you need to take care of the assets that you have. What really is really important is that there is this awareness now that asset management is a really important part of maintaining, upkeeping, and planning your infrastructures. Asset management is crucial for that. And if you organize that in a good way, you reap the benefits from that. Without good and transparent asset management, you will not be able to plan ahead. You don't have the data. You don't know how your infrastructure is performing. There are a lot of things that you do not know. What are the costs? What are the risks? What's the performance? That you do not know, and with asset management you do know that, and if you do that in a structured way, the process becomes transparent, and there is you could say there are more cost savings, but there are savings in that respect. The maintenance challenge is actually becoming more and more important, because most of our infrastructures have been built, they have been constructed after in Europe, mostly after the Second World War. We have rebuilt our infrastructures, and here the challenge is when do we need to replace those infrastructures that we have built, because they might be 60, 70 or 80 years old. Well, maybe not 80, but they are quite old now, and perhaps they need to be replaced. And because we put so many new assets at that time into the ground, we now are running into a period where we need to replace more of these assets. But the management part is interesting, because you need to plan ahead. There's an asset management part that looks ahead, but there's also a strategic asset management part which looks even further ahead. So a typical asset manager might look 5 to 7 or 10 years ahead, but when we look at our assets from a strategic perspective, from a portfolio perspective, we might be looking ahead for 20, 30 or 40 years. More and more we see that the asset managers of different networks start to talk to each other. They are starting to collaborate in the Netherlands, because there are tighter budgets, but we also see that we are more dependent on each other. So, and also the public, for example, if we take an example of replacing cables in the ground or sewage in the ground, the public or the people living in that street, they don't want to have in January the sewage replaced, and they don't want to have in March then the electricity cables replaced. So it's very good that these different asset managers then work together replacing infrastructure. So plus it's also cheaper. Plus most of the asset managers in the Netherlands, they are public companies or publicly owned companies, which means that we as a society have a societal benefit when we start replacing infrastructure together. Now, what is required to have these asset managers work together? First of all, they need to realize that other asset managers are coping with the same problems and the same challenges. And I think in the Netherlands we have made that step already. But after realizing that you have the common problem, well, that's also one of the results, I think, of NGI, is also let's work together and fix that problem. And working together on problems that are shared is something that we're starting with right now. And there are a lot of examples of good projects where different asset managers learn from each other. We also, from the university, we have organized some of these projects. And they're really fruitful and helpful in organizing this culture of getting to know each other and helping each other and working together. Standardization is more than the hardware. Yes, it's also what you do as an organization. There are different types of standardization. You could standardize with respect to technology that you use, standardize with respect to certain designs, design principles, design standards that there are. But you can also standardize your process. And in the Netherlands, currently, a lot of asset managers and their organizations are standardizing their process. What really is really important is that there is this awareness now that asset management is a really important part of maintaining, upkeeping, and planning your infrastructures. Asset management is crucial for that. And if you organize that in a good way, you reap the benefits from that.